Welcome friends once again to this new session on Gems of Geometry, and today we are going to discuss another theorem. So the theorem says the locus of a point equidistant from two intersecting lines is the angle bisector of the angles between the intersecting lines. So this is the theorem which we are going to prove. Before that, let's understand what's the meaning of locus. So locus word comes from Latin origin. So in Latin, locus means place, location, right? And what does locus mean in mathematics, especially in geometry, is nothing but it is a set of all points. It could be a line segment, a curve, or a surface. So it's basically a set of points such that the points satisfy certain conditions, right? Certain conditions. So any set of points which satisfy one particular condition will be called a locus of that particular point. So if you see, if there is a point which is equidistant from a given point on a plane of the paper, and today we know that is called a circle. So once again, so let's say there's a point O, and we are trying to find out a set of points P which are equidistant from O. That means the distance OP stays constant, is nothing but, if you trace it out, you will find that this is nothing but a circle, isn't it? If you draw a circle, then all the points on the circle are equidistant from a particular point called the center of the circle, right? So hence, this particular path or this particular trace will be called the locus of point P. Okay, so it will go and, you know, form a circle like that. So don't go by the, you know, the drawing. So basically, if you take a circle, so this is a circle, let's say. So hence, every point on the circumference is equidistant from the center. So hence, it is called the locus of this point, which is equidistant from a particular given point O, right? So hence, circle becomes a locus of a point P. So now, we are going to discuss, in this case, the locus of a point. Again, we have to trace the path of a point such that it is equidistant from two intersecting lines. So in this case, if you see, L and M are two intersecting lines, and we have a point P which is equidistant from both the lines. So what does equidistant mean? If you drop a perpendicular, let's say like these two perpendiculars, if you drop, let's say this is A and this is B, then we know that OA is equal to OB. That's what we know. And now we have to find out the locus of this point P. Locus means if I have another P here, if I drop perpendiculars like that, they are again equal. Then if I join all such point P's, right? For example, here also, if there is a point like that and they are equidistant, it is equidistant from this thing. So the theorem says that if you join all of them like that, you will see that this line which you will get after joining all of them, will be nothing but the angle bisector of the angle between the lines L and M. So let's try and prove this. So I hope that you understood the theorem. Now let's understand. Let's try and prove this theorem. Now how to prove this theorem? So let's say this point was P. This point is P. I am rewriting it. This is P. Okay, and we have dropped two perpendiculars, PA and PB. So now we know that PA is equal to PB. PA is equal to PB. It's, you know, because they are, B point P is equidistant from both L and M. Correct. Now what? You join. So let's say given PA is equal to PB. And we have constructed PA perpendicular to L and PB perpendicular to M. Correct? This is what we have done. And now what we need to prove that, to prove what? So we are saying that if point P lies on the angle bisector of OAB. So we have to prove that angle AOP is equal to angle BOP. This is what we need to prove. Correct? So hence, we have already joined OP. Now if you say, in triangles, in triangle OPA and triangle OPB. What do we know? PA is equal to PB. Why? It's given. The point P is equidistant. Correct. Now, angle PAO is equal to angle POA. POA. PAO. It was correct actually. PAO is equal to PBO. Why? Both are equal to 90 degrees because PA was perpendicular to L and PB was perpendicular to M. Right? And OP is equal to OP, common side. Correct? Common side. So hence, what do we infer? We infer that, therefore, triangle OPA is congruent to triangle OPB, by which rule? RHS congruence criteria. Correct. So if they are congruent, that means this implies, what do we know now? Angle POA will be equal to angle POB. And why is this? CPCT. Right? That means if a point P is equidistant from both the lines, then it is also lying on the angle bisector of the, you know, the angle which is formed by intersection of the two given lines. So hence proved. Hence, points which are equidistant from two intersecting lines also lie on the angle bisector of the angle formed by the lines. Okay, so this is what we learned. So this is what we learned, right? So this is nothing but, in other way we can say that, the locus of all such point P which are equidistant from the two given line is nothing but a angle bisector of the given angle.